Has a reputation of gentleness. But stage one of the Dakar will give competitors a taste of the severity of the Sahara. The sandy stretches varied by detours through forests of pine and cork trees, where trajectories are calculated to the nearest millimeter. Make the journey with Team Mitsubishi. Every time we race, you win. The 2007 Dakar Rally, only on Supersport.
The 2007 Dakar, the toughest rally in the world. Live the adventure, only on Supersport. Proudly brought to you by Total Quartz Lubricants.
Hello and welcome to Lisbon and the 2007 Dakar Rally. For the second time in its history, the event starts from the seafaring capital of Portugal, and the defending champions are back. In the bike category, Marc Cómar and KTM return to defend their crown. While on four wheels, former Alpine ski champion turned racer Luc Alphon returns with Mitsubishi. For centuries, adventurers have left the Portuguese capital of Lisbon, voyaging into the unknown and crossing uncharted wilderness, pushing the boundaries of human endeavour. As it was for the great navigators like Vasco da Gama, so it is for the modern adventurers, who for the second time assemble in Lisbon to begin their personal voyages of discovery into the unknown on the 2007 Dakar Rally. From its start in the heart of Lisbon, the route takes in the first two stages on Portuguese soil. Competitors will breathe African air for the first time in Morocco, crossing the Atlas Mountains as they travel for 3 days through the country and over 2,000 kilometers. Mauritania and the Sahara Desert await. And for those who survive until the rest day, they will feel they may have broken the back of the event. But there's more torture to come. Crossing into Senegal, 4 days and 2,000 kilometers separate them from the end of one of life's great adventures. Those that complete the trip will certainly never forget their 2007 Dakar adventure. And race director David Castera has worked hard throughout 2006 to ensure that this year's event is a varied one. He says, more than that, we've tried to make sure that every stage will be as difficult and as different as possible. We won't have stages that are 100% rocky or 100% sandy. They'll have different elements in every day. Mauritania, of course, will be the most difficult part, but Morocco mustn't be underestimated. There could be some big surprises. is there. The three big stages will be Zora, Tuata, Atar, Tichit, Tichit, Neymar.
Trois grosses spéciales vont se situer là pour ce Dakar.
In addition to making the route challenging for the spectators, this year's Dakar focuses more than ever on the safety concerns, both for the local population and, of course, for the competitors themselves. ASO, the organising body, has redoubled its efforts under leader Etienne Lavigne. He says, we've even made a special danger map for the service roads. Our team's been out identifying all the roads and tracks, and checking on the danger levels, rating them using a colour scheme of orange through red to black, the most dangerous. Every participant's been given a copy of the map marking all these potential danger spots, and in the most dangerous places, there'll be dedicated police and safety patrols.
Sont précisés. Et en fonction de cette carte, on a mis en place des moyens de police et des renforts de gendarmerie dans les endroits sensibles. Voilà.
In addition, the organizers have made a special safety film which has been shown to all the participants throughout the scrutineering process. On this year's Dakar, there are 264 competitors entered. Around 30% of them might just make it to Dakar. For the rest, the torture on bodies and machinery will just prove too much, and they'll fall by the wayside. It's a superhuman test of endurance, particularly for the two-wheel competitors. Spaniard Marc Comar claimed his first Dakar win last year, and he returns to defend his title with an improved 690cc KTM as part of the powerful Repsol squad. The bike's even lighter than before, more compact and easier to ride, reckons Comar. And that means it's less physically demanding. That helps the riders fight fatigue, which is everyone's enemy. His teammate Giovanni Sala finished on the Dakar podium in third last year. And he too has one of the new machines at his disposal. Well, of course, I'd like to do better than last year, but unfortunately, I haven't ridden in any rallies since the end of last year's Dakar, so really I'm suffering from a lack of competitive form and particularly navigation practice. I have been doing some training, but I've been riding ordinary bikes and not the rally raid machines. So my goal is to finish on the podium, hopefully in a better position than last year. I'll have to push really hard, because in life, if you don't take a risk, you don't get anything. Well, last year the Gauloises team couldn't quite match their Repsol rivals. Cyril Desprez won the most stages of any rider, 4 in total, yet he still missed out on a podium finish. The 2005 winners out for revenge. I'm really looking forward to taking the start of this event and winning it, he says, because another second place would just be meaningless. Supporting him will be Dutch newcomer Frans Verhoeven. The water carrier's job is not an enviable one, but it's vital for success. David Casteur will again play second fiddle to Isidre Estevé. Last year, he crashed out, and he sees it as unfinished business. This year's bike's got nothing in common with last year's model, says Isidre. The chassis is different, the engine, everything completely changed. And I'm really enjoying riding it more. The frame's stiffer, it's easier to jump. You can do whatever you like with this machine. The bike really makes you feel completely at ease.
In definitive, it's a moto that transmits more confidence, which I think is all about.
With perhaps a US rider's best ever chance of a podium finish on the Dakar, Chris Blaise has the motivation to succeed, if not the latest kit in his Red Bull team.
It's the older one, but it's newer than the one I've ridden previously. So this is actually the same bike that the Gauloises used last year. So it's proven, it's made it, and I'm the only one on this one. So could be an advantage, hopefully.
Norwegian rider Paul Anders Ullevsæter has been the top privateer for the last few Dakars. Once again, what he lacks in the latest equipment, he more than makes up for in terms of enthusiasm and determination. John de Azevedo will be the top South American this year. He's got a brother in the truck race, so it's a real family affair. Jānis Vintars is part of a Latvian presence on this year's Dakar that's bigger than ever, with entries in the bike, car and truck categories. And Eastern European influences are a strong theme for 2007. Marek Dabrowski and Jacek Szachor are running for the All-In KTM team from Poland. Top rider from Africa is Mali-born Alain Duclos. He's another on the near ubiquitous KTM mark, but his approach is slightly different. Well, we decided to move up in capacity with a 710cc bike, and that puts us into the open class. I've always had the same two mechanics, and I have a new teammate from Mauritania, and my friend Pepe from Senegal as well. So we've got more ambitious goals, but also better equipment, so you know, we'll see, knowing that the last steps are always the most difficult.
Les dernières marches sont toujours beaucoup plus difficiles.
Gauloises Yamaha rider David Fretinier has an enviable reputation with numerous stage wins under his belt, but he's yet to crack the big one. Loyal to Yamaha, could this be his year? Portuguese local Helder Rodriguez may not be on the podium in Dakar, but locals sprung real surprises on last year's Portuguese stages. Don't bet against one of them leading as they get to Morocco. Antoine Morel is an old hand at the Dakar, but this year's son Alain joins him in their two-man team. Like most of their rivals in the quad category, they use Can-Am machinery. One question remains though, are they less mad than the bike riders, or more? This year's entry in the car category boasts 185 competitors, and at the front are likely to be the men in red from Mitsubishi. They're the defending champions and they have a huge legacy of success. Last year's winner, Luc Alphand, an Alpine ski champion, has got the world resting on his shoulders. He'll have to beat everyone, including his illustrious teammates.
Well,
since last year, says Luke, it seems to me that I've still got quite a lot to improve in terms of my driving, my technique, and even in terms of experience. But we've had a good season. We've won in Patagonia, we won in Dubai, and we finished on the podium in the Trans-Iberico Rally. And in Tunisia, I had my first big accident, so it was really a full season. We're also working on the new car throughout the year, and I hope to be a bit faster myself. Certainly, we've got more kilometers under my belt now than before. I'm back as favorite, and I'm really looking forward to getting this thing underway. Nani Roma in the Mitsubishi team won on two wheels in 2004. 2006, his first year with the Mitsubishi squad, he was on the podium in third. But between then and this year, it's been a tough time. Life is tough, he says. You have to go on. You have to fight, though. I've changed co-drivers, my new co-driver, Lucas, and things are going well. Even though we don't have much experience of each other, we haven't competed together. I think it's going to be okay. Life is hard, and we've got to do a good race for Henri. He refers to co-driver Henri Magne, who was killed in an accident co-driving on this year's Rally Morocco. Well, tens of thousands of man-hours have gone into the planning, design and construction of the latest Pajero. Over 12,000 kilometres of testing have helped to improve and refine the concept to a point where it's now ready for the ultimate test. With 20 years of Dakar experience, there can have been few better prepared entries. Stefan Peter Hansel runs through the changes. He said the exterior has changed radically, particularly on the front with a new model line coming through. Most important changes, though, are invisible. The concept is completely different. The chassis is all new. We've put everything as low as possible to lower the center of gravity. And that's the real main change compared to last year's machine. We've also changed the suspension geometry to make the car better balanced, and the cockpit's been enlarged as well, so it's more comfortable for the drivers. And finally, the aerodynamics have also helped to gain us just a little more in terms of top speed.
C'est l'aérodynamique. Comme on a changé un peu la forme de l'avant, on a un meilleur aérodynamique qui nous permet de gagner encore quelques kilomètres heure en vitesse de pointe.
And the drivers aren't just concerned with testing and racing. There's huge global interest in this event. Mitsubishi driver Hiroshi Masuoka brings Japanese TV viewers up to speed on the changes to the latest Pajero. And there'll be huge support for the crew back home. Not just interested fans and media, but Mitsubishi's engineers also taking a good look at the latest evolution of their arch rival, Volkswagen's Race Touareg. Like the Mitsu, it's an all-new machine, and like Mitsubishi, it's got a stellar lineup. Carlos Sainz, Jeneil de Villiers, and even Ari Vatanen in the four-man squad. I'm really a beginner at this, says multiple World Rally Champion Carlos Sainz. I've only done it once, but I think that even that amount of experience is going to be precious. I hope everything will be okay, especially, he says, I really want to avoid mechanical problems. The rally's so long, you have to be very patient. In terms of mileage, it's almost the equivalent of an entire World Rally season. He's not kidding. And to take on and beat arch rivals Mitsubishi, Volkswagen have to put in every effort. Like their rivals, the team from Wolfsburg have lived, eaten and slept the Race Touareg 2 and its TDI diesel motor since the Dakar ended a year ago.
The team and we've done a lot of work throughout the year. We've had a lot of tests where we improved the car, a lot of rallies as well. So I think, you know, our preparations were quite good for this year. I think the opposition has also done a good job throughout the year, so obviously they'll also be quicker. But I hope that we will have improved a little bit more.
He might look like their favourite uncle, but Ari Vatanen had added four Dakar wins to his World Rally Championship titles before the parents of these young fans were probably even born.
In life, everything is unexpected. You never know what happens tomorrow. No, I was not thinking that I would be here today, but life is full of fantastic surprises, sometimes less fantastic surprises. Life is unpredictable, but this is a nice surprise.
TDI Power won the world's greatest motor race endurance event this year at Le Mans. Can VW's Fab Four bring home the desert endurance crown as well? Only time will tell. Huge local media attention for the VW crews, courtesy of Carlos Sainz, but that was dwarfed by national hero Carlos Sousa's Volkswagen, a multiple Portuguese Baja champion. He was even playing host to the Deputy Prime Minister. Such is the profile of the event in his native land. As the Dakar's only female winner, Jutta Kleinschmidt brings huge experience to the BMW X-Ray team. She's paired with former WRC co-driving champion Tina Turner, another all-woman crew. And Jutta says, I think we've got a really good team. Everybody's highly motivated. I really love the atmosphere with my teammates Gilan Shishiri and Nasser Al-Attiyah. They're very fast, hugely motivated. And I'm driving again with Tina. Very happy about that. So everything's really looking up. The only thing we need now is a little bit of luck. Skis on the Dakar, not Luc Alphon, no, it's European extreme skiing champion Gilan Shishiri, abandoning the snowy piece of his hometown Tignia for the sandy ones in Dakar, joining Kleinschmidt in the X-Ray team. It's a singleton entry for Jean-Louis Schlesser with a new Le Mans prototype look to the rear end of his reliable buggy. But inside, it's the same old Schlesser. Our first objective, to avoid problems, and if we don't have any, then there's a good chance you can count on us being on the podium. It's all down to my co-driver, he says. No pressure there, then. Arnaud Depron has the answer. He says, the co-driver's all right. I'm putting all my hopes on the driver. Abandoning the ice of the Trophy Andros for once, World Touring Car Championship star Ivan Muller is co-driven on this Dakar by two-time winner René Metsch. Huge experience and speed. Minute Fiat 4x4 Pan Dakar also has huge driving talent with Bruno Sabi and double World Rally champion Mickey Biazion. But they haven't got the smallest car. That's Frenchman Georges Marx's 2CV. Two engines, four-wheel drive, but only 30 horsepower. That really is the spirit of the Dakar.
Hello!
The truck field again is likely to be led by Russian veteran Vladimir Chagin. The five-time winner wants to get back onto the top step of the podium after being pushed into second place by then-teammate Firas Khabirov in 2006. The good news for Chagin, Khabirov is not back to defend his title. The bad news is the opposition will be stronger than ever. After a year away, the De Roy truck is back. Last year, they didn't make it through scrutineering. So worried moments as they went into the big hall for technical checks. Okay, so we've made it through tech yesterday. I think it'll be a very competitive rally, he reckons, especially with so many Dutch drivers. Hopefully, it'll be a great Dakar.
Specifiek de Nederlanders wat truc aangaat. Dus ik denk dat echt een mooie en een felle rally kan worden.
Well, we saw his brother in the bike department. And here is the truck side of the family. Andrea de Azevedo is in the 503 Tatra. In 2006, the Dakar once again proved itself to be the toughest motorsport challenge known to man. In the motorcycle category, two KTM teams would slug it out for supremacy, the Repsol and Gauloise squads. As great as their battle with each other, the two-wheeled stars also had to fight every biker's enemy, the Dakar itself. 2005 winner Cyril Desprez took the lead soon after arriving in Africa. But this time, luck was not on his side. He dislocated his shoulder in a fall. It looked like his chances had gone, but incredibly, he battled on. Isidé Estrebe led the charge for the Gauloise squad. Right at the front throughout the early part of the event, he was forced to retire after a crash on the same stage that claimed the life of Australian Andy Caldicott. Marc Kumar now took up the running, and although he didn't win another stage, the Spaniard preserved his lead to the end. It was a tough battle. Desprez won four stages, Kumar none, but the Repsol rider had the upper hand, claiming his first Dakar win from Desprez and Giovanni Sala in third. For most, though, victory is not even a dream. Their reason for entering this mythical event, simply to take on the greatest challenge in motorsport and to survive the worst that nature can throw at them, to finally reach Dakar. Africa's a continent of extremes. Technology meeting the primal forces of nature head on. The battle on four wheels mirrored that on two. Two giants, each looking for an advantage. 2005 winner Stefan Peterhansel led the charge for defending champions Mitsubishi. But rivals Volkswagen mounted a stiff challenge with their race Tuaregs. David's to Mitsubishi's Goliath perhaps, but wins on three of the first four stages showed they meant business. Jeanil de Villiers took up the battle for Volkswagen, hounding the Mitsubishis all the way. While leading a three-car entry, former winner Jean-Louis Schlesser won a stage, but was never quite close enough to the leaders. With over 20 years' experience, the Japanese giant looked to have the upper hand, but which driver would win? For a long time, it seemed Stefan Peterhansel would add to his six bike wins with a third four-wheeled victory. Ski champion Luke Alphon thought his chances have gone, losing time after a crash, and Peterhansel's experience seemed to be paying off once more. Till 2 days from the end, a crash turned the table as victory slipped from his fingers. Luke Alphon found himself leading not only the Mitsubishi team, but also the Dakar, confirming his first Dakar win with two stage victories. The Frenchman led home Volkswagen's de Villiers, Nani Roma claiming third for Mitsubishi. It was a great result for Repsol, with Alphon and Kumar winning on four wheels and two. The first stage is expected to attract even more fans than last year. It features the worst the Portuguese mountains can throw at the competitors, and after foggy mornings for the last 2 days, poor visibility may make the stages even more treacherous. No one wants to drop too far behind, but to end their event in Portugal would be a disaster.
The 2007 Dakar, the toughest rally in the world. Live the adventure, only on Supersport. Proudly brought to you by Total Quartz Lubricants.